Oh my God, it's insane, like what Sydney has turned over, you know, and what they refuse to turn anything over. And now we're at the place where they want Mike to waive all attorney-client privilege so they can then have carte blanche over everything that Mike has in his, and Sydney in his possession that has to do with Covington's part of this whole scam, this whole massive collapse of his original attorneys.
Well, and then, so there's a sentencing hearing on December 18th, 2018.
Yes.
A year after his plea.
Right.
And the prosecutors say, well, you know, General Flynn has been helpful to the government on these other cases, so we recommend zero time in prison. For this one count of lying to the FBI.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And then Judge Sullivan goes off on this.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be kind. He went off the rails.
Yeah, okay. It was outrageous. It was slanderous. He accused Mike of treason.
Yeah.
Said, you turned your back. I mean, he was hugging the American flag. It was a show and frightening to sit there and watch.
So then he calls a recess. He walks out, goes to his chambers for a while, and then comes back and apologizes to General Flynn that he, the judge, was wrong and off base, correct?
Yeah, but the damage was already done.
Right.
And for the record, you know, sitting behind us were every bit of all of the fake news mainstream media. They're all taking notes. And they are writing it down, and it's instantly, they all run out, and it's instantly out there that the judge just accused General Flynn of treason. I mean, that's the number one, that's the most horrible thing you can ever accuse General Mike of, you know.
Yeah, right.
He bleeds red, white, and blue, but the damage was done by that that moment, by that particular judge.
And at that point,
I'll never forget.
And at that point, prior to that hearing, his attorneys, which are not Sidney Powell at this point, which are still Covington, they said, if the judge asks you if you stand behind your guilty verdict, you tell him you're standing, correct? Again, bad advice.
Horrible advice, you know. And again, remember the Mueller special coup, I call it, was still going on. So they still had young Mike, they still had their hands around young Mike's neck. So my brother is always thinking, you know, I've got to protect my child, you know, because we're going to give young Mike and my brother what they called the Manafort treatment, okay, which is, you know, just like they did with Roger Stone. They take 26 FBI agents, 6 o'clock in the morning, they were going to do this to my brother and young Mike and anybody else. Lori, his wife, my brothers and sisters, they'll do this to anyone. We now know, and don't think for one second they wouldn't do it. So they were going to give young Mike and my brother the Manafort treatment if Mike didn't listen to, you know, the Covington, I mean, telling him to plead guilty. I mean, so I have to keep reminding myself that Mueller's special coup was still going on. Mm-hmm. So there was a big danger to young Mike's life. And they would have destroyed him. They would have put young Mike in prison instantly. And there's nothing you can do. It's unbelievable KGB tactics.
Now, at this point, General Flynn fires Covington.
Yep.
And Sidney Powell, which I believe is the game changer here, rides in.
Yeah.
And Sidney Powell becomes General Flynn's attorney in June of 2019.
Yes, I know. I mean,
she starts going through the documents and says, holy camoly, this is a huge issue. She files a motion that the prosecutors are withholding evidence, even though they were told in December 12th, 2017, to hand over all the information that shows General Flynn is in it. She files a motion, says, hey. These people. This is way too kind. They are holding back in spite of this court order, And the prosecutors, after she files this, admit in November of 2019 that, well, as you mentioned, well, you know, Patinkin's notes were really Strzok's, and Strzok's were really Patinkin's. Yeah. And, well, yeah, well, there's a couple things. We did withhold some stuff. And they turned some things over, but not a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
And then good old Judge Sullivan steps in December of 2019 and says, well, you know, because General Flynn pled guilty in December of 2017 and to this one count, and because, well, when I asked him in December of 2018 if he still wanted to hold the guilty plea when Covington was telling him to do that, no matter what the judge asked him, he said, yeah, okay, I still stand behind my guilty plea. He goes, well, I don't think I'm going to, well, because he filed the guilty plea, well, I don't think the prosecutors have to turn over evidence that shows that he's in fact innocent. But that's contrary to what Judge Sullivan ruled on December 12, 2017, when he said, hand over the exculpatory evidence. Okay, so that happens, Barb.
First, he's the Brady guy. He's going to, everyone needs to turn over all exculpatory evidence. And, you know, and we're all like, yes, he's really going to force them to turn over all of the original 302s, all of the things that Sidney has been asking. And then all of a sudden he flips, and he doesn't care if he doesn't make them turn over anything. So
and then the prosecutors come in January 7th, 2020 and say, you know how we said that General Flynn shouldn't have any time in prison? Well, we think it should be from 0 to 6 months, up to 6 months in prison.
Well, they were angry because they lost the Farrah case. Okay, the Farrah case in the EDVA, which is in Virginia, you know, the Eastern District of Virginia, collapsed. And they were hoping, because they found out in that case that there was nothing that they had done wrong, that they interviewed all these FBI agents, they had forensic FBI agents looking at every dime they, you know, that interchanged all of their hands. And this is all of Mike's company. This isn't just his partner. They were targeting his partner to get at Mike, to you know, call him a witness, and now they changed it to a co-conspirator, and we're going to have your son come back in, and we're going to have him go on the witness stand. So this thing collapsed. The Farrah case ended. It collapsed. It was thrown out by Judge Trenga, thank God, and that's what really angered Van Krock and all the DOJ thugs, the leftover Mueller thugs. They lost a big case when they lost that Farrah case against Mike's company and Mike's partner, actually. But it was really against Mike, because then they could throw those charges at him too, because they were constantly throwing those, you know, hovering those charges over his head to get his son.
So when the prosecutors did this, I believe, Barb, on January 7, 2020, and said, you know what, we're recommending up to 6 months in prison now. But forget about what we said before about him helping us out. Okay.
Right.
I think they drastically underestimated General Flynn and Sidney Powell, the warriors. They thought that they were going to cave. They thought your family was going to cave. But instead, General Flynn and Sidney come back and say, you know what? Guess what? We're withdrawing our original guilty plea. This is on January 14th.
Right.
And then Sidney comes in and says, oh, by the way, we have a witness that saw the original 302 that said General Flynn didn't lie. And then Devin Nunes, as you stated, jumped in and said, oh, FBI briefed us and said the same thing. Right?
Right. Okay. There's a lot of stuff that's still coming out too, Dave. Like, just so everybody knows, there's a lot more that is about to hit too.
And then when Sidney and General Flynn bit back on these, I believe, deep state criminal prosecutors, what happened was, all of a sudden, when they bit back, Van Grack, now the lead prosecutor, because, well, we'll talk about Jesse Liu in a minute and Deborah Curtis, but who were also assigned to the case, who are no longer. Van Grack comes back and goes, you know what, we were just kidding. Forget that thing about 6 months. We're going back to our original that it should be no time in prison. Well, then Sidney, that was on January 20th, 2020. On January 22nd, 2020, Sydney submitted a sentencing memorandum about this whole thing should be thrown out. On the 29th, she issued a motion to dismiss for egregious governmental misconduct. And General Flynn entered a declaration on January 29th, 2020.
Right. And Lori, too. Poor Lori, his wife. He had to do one, too. An affidavit. It's a sworn affidavit for people that are not sure what that meant.
Barb, I want to read just a couple segments of the Mr. Flynn's motion to dismiss for egregious government misconduct and in the interest of justice. Just a couple quick things that was just how it started. Michael T. Flynn hereby moves to dismiss the charges against him for outrageous government misconduct and in the interest of justice. This motion is based on exculpatory evidence, so-called Brady material, as well as egregious government misconduct that was discovered after Mr. Flynn's motion to compel Brady material and related briefing. These documents contain remarkable new Brady evidence that the prosecution has long suppressed. For instance, this evidence not only belies the bogus FARA, F-A-R-A, false statement charges Mr. Van Grack leveraged against Covington and Mr. Flynn, but also demonstrates Mr. Van Grack knew these charges were bogus, yet sought to have Mr. Flynn make a false statement in his Virginia interview on June 25, 2019 against his partner Bijan Rafikian, and was encouraging subornation of perjury by Mr. Flynn. In other words, General Flynn, you lie for us. You need to lie for us in this other trial. General Flynn refused to do that, which, as you mentioned, really upset the criminal prosecutors, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, they thought they could intimidate General Mike, and now here is Sidney with him. And, you know, they wanted Mike to make a statement that wasn't true. And, you know, of course, thank God Sidney's listening to the whole thing, and there's other lawyers listening, too. And it turned into a big blow-up, too. They were all... You know, Sydney, she went to town with that, and of course Mike and those guys knew that was it, that it's over. You know, there's no work, there was no reasoning with these people. They wanted Mike's scalp. So that's where it really had to end then. But it had to be perfect timing too, Dave. You know, like everything had to fall into place. You know, the Mueller disaster's over, things are getting exposed every day. And of course, Sydney had to have time. They dumped all these files because they have to turn over everything. Covington had to turn over a couple of years worth of thousands and thousands and thousands of documents. And she had to go look through everything to piece it together. And Mike, too, the two of them just combing through everything. And then they see the false statements and they see the FARA filing and they find, you know, where Van Grack crossed a line out in a statement on the FARA charge, you know, and they find all this stuff where Covington didn't show Mike any of this. They were going to save Covington. They weren't going to help General Flynn.
They were setting him up on the inside.
In fact, I sat in the trial when they went through the FARA trial. And Covington, Kellner, was one of the witnesses, and he got up there and he said he was a never-Trumper.
This is Kellner, who was the attorney for General Flynn from Covington.
From Covington. Gets up on the witness stand, and luckily, thank God, the defense attorney said to Kellner, Mike's original attorney, you know, did you vote for Trump or something like that? And I loved the question. I was like, here we go. Because my brothers and sisters and I knew all along there was something horrible. And anyway, so he said, yeah, I'm a never Trumper. I mean, I nearly...
And proud of it.
I nearly jumped out of my seat because it was like boom, you know, like I knew it, you know, you POS, you know, like we knew all along that you were undermining Mike and you were talking to these guys behind his back. And now, I mean, I got this document, and maybe it's the conversation between Kellner and Anthony, this guy Steve Anthony, between Covington lawyers and Brandon Van Grock, and also Ahmad Zainab. She's another piece of work. If you want me to, I could pretend like I could read it so people can hear the conversation that's going on, because I've read it myself a couple of times. I don't know if you want to ask me another question or let me read the summary of a meeting between these clowns, these thugs.
Well, no, you're welcome to read it, Barb.
Okay. It's not very long, but this is November 1st in 2017.
November 21st, 2017. Yeah. So in context, November 21st, 2017, this is prior to General Flynn signing a plea deal.
Right.
About a week before.
Yeah, this is a week before. So December 1st, more than that. So this is a meeting with special counsel's office, and I'll just kind of go through who's in there. Robert Kellner, Stephen Anthony, Brandon Van Grock, Zainab Ahmad, and they're at the special counsel's office. And it's from about 1 o'clock to about 1:45.
So Kellner and Anthony are General Flynn's attorneys from Covington.
Right.
Van Grack and Ahmad Zainab are from the prosecution.
Right. And I'll just throw this out. So Van Grack is still on Mike's case. Okay. He's still one of the prosecutors. Zainab Ahmad was one of the original prosecutors, but she's gone, slithered away, and she, remember, this is November 1st, 2017, Zainab Ahmad was briefed about the fake Russian dossier with Weissman the summer of 2016, so she already knew the Russian dossier was fake, okay, she's bad news. So anyway, here's the conversation, this is a summary of the meeting. One of the other lawyers writes the notes, and I have her name too, but that's not. So Brandon Van Grack, we wanted to invite you here because we know it has been a couple of months since we've spoken. You guys have been very cooperative with us and quiet in the media, and we really appreciate that. This is a Thug Van Grack. We have a number of decision points that we're going to have to make, and we wanted to gauge your interest in talking to us before we have to make those decisions. General Flynn has said a number of things regarding having a story to tell, and we'd like to explore that. And then Kellner now says, this is Mike's attorney, General Flynn very much wants to cooperate. Mike doesn't even know they're having this conversation, right? We have spent a lot of time talking to him about what he knows. At the end of the day, there are a few things we don't quite know what to make of. There are some issues not related to Russia that he has questions about. You all might have specific things you could present to him to refresh his recollection. You don't think that there is a smoking gun, but we are open to making General Flynn available. I mean, I just want to throw up. So in other words, Mike doesn't know they're talking like this to these clowns, and it's almost like they're going to give him up to these guys, you know? He might have something he can say about Trump, because remember, these guys are never Trumpers. This is how deep the deep state swamp is. Okay, so I'll keep going. So Van Grack says, there is information that you or your client might not be aware of. From where we're sitting, there might still be value in sitting down with your client. We have a good sense of what Flynn knows and what Flynn doesn't know. And then his lawyer, Kellner, says, refreshing recollection is key with General Flynn. He often doesn't have a sense of what is important and tends to forget even mundane things. I mean, how insulting. In other words, they're saying he's not going to he's not the brightest guy. I mean, that's the way I'm looking at it. I just want to take my hands and slap them. And then Van Grock says, we feel confident that your client has value to provide. This isn't supposed to be a gotcha interview. This is meant to get input from your client for our broader investigation. This is before he pleads, okay? December 1st, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Kellner says, I can imagine ways in which we come in. Agreeing only to a pro offer could put him at risk. We don't want our client charged or found guilty of a felony offense. We don't think he has committed a felony offense. It would be helpful to get more details about where you are going. I mean, so Kellner is telling them November 1st before Mike pleads that he hasn't committed a felony and there's no clear felony. They're not saying he lied or anything here, you know? Like, I mean, everybody in the world thinks Mike had lied by then and it's not true. Mm-hmm. So here comes Zainab Ahmad. She's bad news. We've given you the universe of charges. I don't know if we can provide any additional assurances beyond what we've already mentioned. If he gives us useful information, we can talk and negotiate from there. You don't know everything he knows. And then Van Brock chimes in, no decisions have been made with respect to Flynn because we want to talk to him first. I'm going to say that again. Okay, November 1st, 2017, before Mike's plea, Van Brock says, no decisions have been made with respect to Flynn because we want to talk to him first. Turkey or Farah wouldn't necessarily be the focus. Questions about the campaign would not be the first thing we talk about. There are things that we know that you and your client would not necessarily have focused on. So they're not going to charge him with Farah. They're not going to charge him with any kind of lie. They want him to start talking, and then they're going to make up their mind what kind of crime they can create from all this nightmare.
In other words, make something up about the president.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, give us something that we can use to take him out. And guess what? The fire thing goes away, which protects you, Covington. And, oh, by the way, that FBI lie thing that really didn't happen, we're just going to let that go. But he has to give us.
Yes, he has to give us what we want.
He has to give us. And if he can't give us that, then he has to make it up.
It's so scary, Dave.
This is a conversation.
From
East Germany with the Stasi, or Stalin's Russia, or Mao's China.
Yep, this is a huge document that Sydney grabbed from all the material that they had to turn over. I mean, so I'll just go on here. So here comes the other attorney, Kellner attorney, Covington attorney. His name is Steve Anthony. This would definitely be a leap of faith on our part. Okay, now Ahmad comes in. The information is much more valuable for us than it might be in a traditional context. Non-smoking gun information is valuable to us. And then Van Brock. Yes, our mission here is to answer questions. And then Kellner. You believe this is information he actually has? And then both Van Brock and Zainab Ahmad. They both at the same time say yes, you know, they're like nodding emphatically, yes, you know, and it says it there. I mean, it's written down. They're both saying yes, like, you know, and after Kellner says, and you believe this is information he actually has, like, you know, I mean, even Kellner doesn't know anything. There's no lie yet. There's no felony lie. There's no Farah violation. There's nothing. And it's November 1st, 2017. Good grief. And then Kellner says, we spent a lot of time trying to elicit information from him. He doesn't have a memory of a lawyer. It would be a very time-consuming process. I mean, these guys, for them, and this is their words, because the person who wrote this is one of their legal staff lawyers writing this memorandum down. This is what's making me so sick. So then they go on. Another Kellner, Covington lawyer, his name is Steve Anthony again. You said that the information would be more valuable today than it would be a month from now. And then Van Brack says yes. And then Zainab Ahmad nods yes. I mean, they just want any information. They're trying to squeeze Mike, okay? That's what the squeeze is. Without Mike knowing this conversation is going on, can you imagine General Mike Flynn, if he knew that these clowns that he hired to defend him were talking like this, and these other clowns, you know, Zainab and Van Brock, who couldn't carry his suitcase, you know, are doing this to a 33-year, you know, military hero. It's sickening. So then Van Brock says this. I'm almost to the end. There's one more issue I want to bring up. One of the charges we mentioned was false statements under Farah because Covington prepared the Farah registration.
Oh, by the way, Covington, guess what? If you don't make this happen, right? Yep. Guess what? You're on the hook. This is what he's telling him.
That's what he's telling him. He says that would make you, Rob Kellner Covington, a fact witness. It isn't something we are considering. So he says, it isn't something we are considering.
Never.
And Kellner says, Rob Kellner Covington, he says, if we were to get to that point, we would litigate it very aggressively. Mm-hmm. And then Zainab Ahmad chimes in, we're not saying it's not waivable. We just want to make sure you talk it through with your client.
You talk it through. In other words, you put the pressure on your client to come up with something on Trump, and guess what? Your butt gets taken out of the sling. Yeah, that conversation was.
You won't charge a FARA violation, so Covington is accused because Covington filled, and they admit that Covington, Van Brock thugs admit that Covington filled out the FARA form too. You know, it's sickening. So then it goes on, and I'm almost done. Van Brock says, we're at a point where we can have a conversation with Flynn with prompts. I will say the value of whatever information he has will be different now than it will be in 2 weeks or a month. We're interested in talking to him, even if he doesn't think he has a smoking gun. I mean, this is sick. And then Steve Anthony of Covington says, what sort of protections are you willing to offer so his words aren't used against him? And then Van Graaff, a pro offer letter. And then Kellner Covington says, queen for a day? I mean, I don't, you know. And then Van Graaff nods yes. And then Rob Kellner Covington says, we would need to discuss that. We need to get comfortable with the situation. We would feel better with something stronger than a pro offer letter like statutory immunity. And then another Covington lawyer, Steve Anthony, says, I have to ask, where are you guys going with respect to charges against General Flynn? This is November 1st, 2017. Mike doesn't know what charges are going to be filed against him. Van Brack says, number one, failure to register. FARA. Failure to register. I mean, Covington filed the FARA. And then number two, FARA false statements. And then number three, false statements to government officials regarding contacts with Russian officials during the transition. And then Kellner, Covington, Steve Anthony says, on the last point, do you mean the White House interview? And then Brandon Van Grack says, false statements at an FBI interview at the White House. And then Rob Kellner, Covington says, frankly, we are surprised by that. That is not consistent with what we have learned from press reports and other sources. And then Steve Anthony says, this is Covington. Would you be willing to give us the 302? And then Brandon Van Brack says, we're not currently in a posture where we're providing that information. We're certainly willing to hear what you have to say.
What a POS.
Yeah. And then they say, and then Van Brack says, we're certainly willing to hear what you have to say if you think that we're wrong. In other words, they're going to lie and make up a false statement crime. They're so bad. So then Zainab Ahmad chimes in. We're not saying no. We'll think about it. You might be entitled to it soon anyway. This is the 302. We feel like we know all we can know short of talking to him. We're at a fork in the road, and we want to talk to him, General Flynn, to decide on how to move forward. And then Kellner says, he would be willing to tell his story if you are in good faith willing to tell us that if he comes in and you think that he's been truthful, that you may not take action against him. However, it would be that the interview is just a way for the special counsel to get information to help its case against General Flynn. I'm going to just repeat that a little better. Kellner says, however, it could be that the interview is just a way for the special counsel to get information to help its case against General Flynn. Sorry, didn't read that very well. And then two more. And then Zainab Ahmad says, thug, look, all options are on the table. No pros. We are like a typical USA's office. We want to get all the facts. It doesn't have to be that he has a smoking gun. We haven't thought a lot about deals. It would all depend on how the interview with Flynn goes. And then the last thing is Covington, and this is Steve Anthony. I'm just imagining getting ready for a trial to begin, thinking to myself, geez, why did I let my client do this interview? I don't know if it makes sense to expose ourselves with only a pro offer letter in return. I mean, so, from just this memorandum of conversations between the Covington lawyers and the DOJ thugs, We know there was no fair crime. There was no lie. They were all going to make this stuff up, you know.
Bob, it was a setup of General Flynn. It was a setup of President Trump. It was a setup of our Constitution. And it was a setup of the rule of law.